Analysts run control samples in repetition. They run the same sample again and again and again. Statistical analysis of the repetitions give them information about the errors that they are producing. The detection limit question is really the same question. What are the errors, and what are those errors, especially down at the very low levels? It works like this. They run controls at, say, for example, 150, and they get a standard deviation of 1.1. So there's a 68% chance that it's between these two values, and a 95% chance that it's between these two values. Okay, what would happen if they had run it instead of at 150? Let's say they'd run it at 130. The assumption that is made is that the standard deviation is independent of the quantitation. In other words, the standard deviation, you run it at 150, you get a standard deviation of 1.1. Let's say they've run it at 120, the standard deviation would still be 1.1. Let's say they run it at 100, the standard deviation would still be 1.1. I want to make a big jump and put the control all the way down to 10. So we're running it at 10. If it's at 10, we have a standard deviation of 1.1. The standard deviation is the same. This is a definition. This is like, nothing is black and white, nothing is cut and dry. This is not an easy concept, in my opinion. I worked in the field for years and before I really understood this. The assumption is made that the standard deviation is independent of the quantitation. We run the controls at a 10. We get a standard deviation of 1.1. That tells us that we know that one standard deviation and two standard deviations are an 8.9 and a 7.8. So we're saying there's a 68% chance that it's between 8.9 and 11.1. And we're saying that there's a 95% chance that it's between 7.8 and 12.2. So what is the detection level? The argument comes down to this fairly simple point. As this 10, with a standard deviation of 1.1, as this 10 gets smaller and smaller and smaller, how small can it get such that we have a 99% certainty that it's not zero? 99 certainty being three standard deviations. How about this as an approach? You run a control at 150 and you know that it's plus or minus 5. If it had been run at 100, it would have been plus or minus 5. If it had been run at 50, it would have been plus or minus 5. If it had been run at 10, plus or minus 5 would have been between 5 and 15. If it had been run at 5, it would be between 0 and 10. Okay? But what if it had been run at 4? If it had been run at 4, then we know for sure that it's between minus 1 and 9. So 5 is our detection limit. So then back up to our initial point. 150 plus or minus 5. I mean, what in the heck does that mean? That's what our standard deviation is about. Our standard deviation is like a language tool that we've been given. It's a definition that people can use to communicate. It's just a definition. It's kind of contrived by people for communication. Instead of saying plus or minus 5, we can say plus or minus one standard deviation, which is 68% certainty, or two standard deviations, which is 95, or three standard deviations. But anyway, standard deviation is a language tool that's used to describe things. And then a last point would be that one of the big players in the analysis field is the Environmental Protection Agency. Probably some of the most sophisticated analyses anywhere are developed by the Environmental Protection Agency to standardize environmental analysis throughout the country and even perhaps throughout the world. The Environmental Protection Agency says 3 times the standard deviation is the MDL, which is the method detection limit. To me, this is not absolute truth. This is not like absolute science, but it's a definition that I can live with without a problem.